name is Sam. You tuned in live right now with your boy, Promise Your Great. Your Renee Akinye Bini Shula, the natural mystical God. I come to you straight for. This is who I am. I am you, and you are me. Where you go, I go. Where I go, you should be. The great. I'm finna give y'all a quick, brief rundown of what's going on right now, because it need to be heard. I see a lot of people out here going crazy because it's so-called coronavirus. You know, I see people posting it, stay home. And, you know, I see everybody wearing masks and gloves and buying sprays and going to the grocery stores and buying up all the goods and stuff. You know, it's almost like something you've seen on TV. You know what I'm saying? Feel like television on. But see, what I'm saying on a higher conscious level is people have really, really lowered their vibration to a level where it comes to a point that they're not even in control of themselves anymore. They're just natural puppets. Puppets of the game. Puppets of the maze. And they all been pulled by screens. Each having expectations of one another. A big reason why they say don't get caught up in materialistic and monetary things. Cars, shoes, clothes, houses. And all this, you know, other stuff that these people get caught up in. The alcohol, you know. It's not for me to tell nobody how to live their life because I became awakened. But it was for me to pass the ball. You know, pass the rock. Most people are just around here sleepwalking. And that's what's going on right now. It all turned into a zombie land. You know what I'm saying? They say, you know, white now and everything, you know, you won't catch the virus, stay at home. And you know what I'm saying? You got people right now trying to play it safe to death. Yeah, they out here playing it safe to equal. But see, what we got to understand, overstand, and understand is death is meant to happen. So if you let anybody tell you that you need to be safe or you won't die, that's hideous. As they would say, that's insane. You're born to die, and you tell me you got to be careful not to do it. That means you should live happily, freely, unworried, and in a total state of peaceful, blissfulness, happiness, love. And then you'll attain the prosperity and abundance. But see, it's not our fault that we've been manipulated and told different. It's not our parents' fault. It's not even ancestors' fault. But our fault is we ain't doing nothing about it. We continue to let them manipulate us. We continue to help them beat us down. Because that's what you're doing. When you're drinking that alcohol, these are spirits that you're attaching to yourself. And that's why people are going crazy and their vibration change when they drink. And that word become drunk, as they say. So you got to be aware of this. From even eating with a fork, silverware. It's known that you are a source of vibration. All have conscious, but the human body also is a very wonderful vibration as well. And if you know how to use your utensils, you can be the next Michelangelo and make the wonderful paintings that you would like to be or have. But you got to know it comes with hard work, consistency, patience, dedication. They say all that you get understanding of. So meaning whatever it is that you're doing, get the knowledge of it. You know, knowledge don't become wisdom until it's applied. So you can get all the information that you want. You can read all the books you want. You can study, you can learn. But until you apply it into your life, you start to notice these so-called obstacles. You know, most times we sit blockers in front of ourselves because of the resistance that we show. We go opposite, astray of our paths. When you were born, it's something that you're supposed to be doing. And the parent's supposed to teach the child until a certain age, and the child's supposed to grasp it and move forward with it. But unfortunately, by the misinterpretation and the misleading and the misteaching, you know, we've been living a different way. And it's the reason why it seems like it's so hard. And it is difficult, but it's never hard. It's a challenge because of whatever been stuck in the brain for so long become natural. So anything new to the brain will become resistant. And that's why they say, you know what I'm saying? If you never did something before, somebody say, hey man, it's hard. If you never built a car before, you gonna say, hey man, it's hard, because the brain ain't never learned how to do it before. But once the brain see now learning how to do it, guess what? It become easy. It's the subconscious mind. So you got to know, for one, who you are. I feel everybody trying to figure out who God is. Is God real? Is God not? No matter what it is, every religion, every belief, I'm going to give you the free game, the free secret. Every book say, know thyself. See, once you know who you are, then you know your capabilities. And once you know your capabilities, then you can apply yourself to your higher capacities. And now you got understanding, overstanding, understanding of who you are, what you come from, and what you can do. And this is what they call awakening, spiritual awakening. You know, becoming aware, awareness. People say when you're aware, you know, oh, I can look over my shoulder, I'm on point. Oh, I got my fire, I got my heat, I'm on point. I got my gun, I'm paying attention, I ain't slipping. That's not true awareness. Because you're actually invoking negative energy to come to you. Think about it. Whatever energy you give out comes back to you. So if you're thinking that you got to be safe because there's so much drama going on, be actually seeing this inside of your subconscious zone, that this is how you got to be. You got to expect something finna happen to you. And that ain't no way to live, baby. You got to know that it's my birthright to be happy. I am free. I ain't got nothing to worry about. Then you start to feel untouchable. Because you know who you are now. You know what you can do. You become the orchestrator. Knowing your true self is the best thing you can ever do. Forget what the other people time out, because that ain't life. You fucking up. It's not your fault, and I can't judge, because I done did the same thing. I done did so much, I would never think that I'd be at where I'm at right now. You know, but see, I always wanted knowledge, and I grasped every time it came to me, no matter how many mistakes I made. You gain a whole nother level of consciousness. You open up glands. You get out of the 3D dimension, and you elevate to the other dimensions. And you start to know that, you know, wow. You feel like you've been played all your life. The messages that they give y'all in the TVs, the phones, the cameras, they spying on you. The phone is not powered off, even when it seems like it's dead. Why you think you can't take the battery out of the phones no more? Like I was just saying earlier about eating with silverware, the forks. It's true power in your own self. So every time you eat the right food that's connected with you, and you touch it with your hand, this is your energy. It's like you're charging this food with an extra vibration, and you consume it. And these forces in your body start to glow. They talk about the chakras that live inside of the body. The will are the elements that's in the body. You got to know where we're coming. A total state of blissfulness is happy. You got to be willing to accept the challenges. Because these challenges build. We get mad every time something ain't going right. We point fingers and blame each other. But see, knowing that all the energy is you. You send something out to you, and the universe send it back. The universe don't go by whether this person got a good heart or not, or I'm going to take it easy on this person. If you send out this energy, this is what's going to come back to you. It's the boomerang effect. Nowhere around. I can't say, hey, I'm going to be nice to you. Then I'm going to go to the other side of town and say, I don't like these people over here. Because get what? When I get back to around the people that I think, you know, we cool with, be my folks over here, somebody, one of my folks, gonna have some type of attitude. And I'm like, damn, why the hell y'all acting like that? It's with me. We home, boy. But I've been out there sending out other bad energy on the other side. So either way, it's gonna come back one way or another. We got to know that. And that's why they say you got to treat all with love on a high level. That's what I say, you know what I'm saying, on the strong survive. You got to know that, okay, cool. I see what's going on. This person got an attitude right now. On a high conscious level, it ain't them. I still got something going on with me inside of myself that I need to fix. So I'm gonna look at this energy right now. I'm gonna approach it. And I'm going to transmute this into a better vibration. And this is what we call transmutation. You're doing this with cycles of the universe, the moon, the sun, the elements, earth, air, fire, water, ether, the water.